गुड आफ्टरनून, एम आई ऑडिबल?
गुड आफ्टरनून सर. यस सर.
ओके, सो इज द स्क्रीन विजिबल टू यू ऑल?
यस सर.
Okay, so good afternoon one and all. Let us begin with our lecture of today. So in the last lecture we had started with the third unit, which is the unit of varied flow. Now what is varied flow? It is another name for a non-uniform flow, in which the flow characteristics or the flow parameters change with respect to space. Okay, that means between any two points you will not find the same flow parameters. The flow parameters are going to change. Cells. Okay, so we had started with the varied flow. Now under varied flow there are two types. First is the gradually varied flow, second is the rapidly varied flow. So in this unit we have first seen what is meant by varied flow, why does varied flow occur in an open channel. Then we started the studying about gradually varied flow. We saw the definition of gradually varied flow. So gradually varied flow is a flow which changes, in which the depth changes over a very long distance. Okay, and we have seen the reasons why a gradually varied flow will occur. Now today we are going to start with the dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. We are going to study its assumption and we are going to derive its equation, and after deriving the equation we will be studying the classification of channel slopes. So let us begin. Okay, so let us begin with the dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. Very important point. Okay, in our examination either the equation, okay, either the derivation or either the assumptions will come. Even in the oral examination you will be asked about either the equation or the assumptions. So this is a very important point, everyone should pay attention. So let us first see, study the assumptions. So before deriving the dynamic equation of gradually varied flow, okay, there are some assumptions that we need to make. Okay, so it is easy for us to derive that equation. So what are the assumptions that we have to make? First, the first assumption that we have to make before deriving the dynamic equation is the channel is a prismatic channel. Now, what is a prismatic channel? Now, we have studied in the first unit, in the classification of open channels, there are two types of channel, prismatic and non-prismatic channel. Now, what is a prismatic channel? The prismatic channel is one in which the cross section and the slope of the channel does not change throughout its length. Okay, ja channel's cross sectional area ani slope throughout the length change honar nahi, constant rahnar, tya channel la apan prismatic channel mhanto. Okay, so the first as our first assumption should be that the channel is prismatic, that is there is no change in cross sectional area and alignment or the slope of the channel. Second, the bed slope of the channel is very small. Okay, now as I have said in the last lecture, there are different types of bed slopes of the channel. Some bed slopes are steep, some bed slopes are critical, and some bed slopes are very mild. So for our gradually varied flow, we'll make an assumption that the bed slope is very small, or that the bed slope is mild. It is not very steep, neither it is critical, it is very mild. Okay, so proceeding to the third assumption, the flow is steady and hence discharge is constant. Though the gradually varied flow comes under a non-uniform flow, okay, gradually varied flow is a type of non-uniform flow, but we will make the assumption that it is a steady flow. Okay, and hence we have, as we have made the assumption that the flow is steady, the discharge capital Q is going to remain constant throughout the channel. The fourth assumption that we will make is the pressure distribution over the channel section is hydrostatic, or the streamlines are practically straight and parallel. So in this assumption, what we are going to consider is that this channel is flowing. Okay, this is section one and section two. Okay, now here pressure distribution, we will assume that if you consider two section, at section one pressure distribution will be similar to hydrostatic pressure distribution. Manje kay, at the surface of water at section one pressure will be zero, and as we go below the pressure is going to increase. Similarly at section two pressure distribution is going to be hydrostatic. Okay, that manje kay, at the surface pressure is going to be zero, and as we go deeper pressure is going to increase, and pressure is going to be maximum at the bed of the channel. Okay, and this pressure distribution will be constant at section 1 and at section 2 as well as the further sections. We have to make that assumption. Okay, now why do we have to make that assumption? It is because if we do not make the assumption that the pressure distribution is hydrostatic, okay, it automatically turns the flow into an unsteady one. जर प्रेशर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन हायड्रोस्टॅटिक आहे असं आपण जर अज्यूम केलं नाही, तर आपोआप ऑटोमॅटिकली काय होऊन जाणार, तुमचं फ्लो अनस्टेडी होऊन जाणार. पण आपण इथं अजम्पशन काय केलेलं आहे, दॅट द फ्लो इज स्टेडी, तर आपलं वरचं अजम्पशन कॅन्सल होऊन जाईल. ओके, सो इन ऑर्डर टू मेक द थर्ड अजम्पशन फिजिबल, दॅट द फ्लो इज स्टेडी, वी शुड मेक द फोर्थ अजम्पशन. नेक्स्ट, the energy correction factor alpha is unity. Now what is energy correction factor? Now as you know, the formula for total energy in an open channel is y plus z plus v square upon 2g. Now as water is flowing through an open channel, water is a real fluid, and for that there is going to be some friction, and the energy is going to reduce as the water is going to flow further and further, the energy is going to reduce. Okay, now in order to make up for the loss in energy, we take a correction factor, which is known as the energy correction factor alpha. Okay, now one of the assumption that we have to make in gradually varied flow dynamic equation is that this energy correction factor is unity. Okay, hesa's artha kay hota, that the total energy remains constant throughout the flow. Jasa aapla Bernoulli's equation madhe apan assume kela hota, the total energy remains constant throughout the flow. So in this case also we will make an assumption that the energy correction factor is unity, or it is one. That means the total energy remains constant throughout the flow. Next assumption that we make is the roughness coefficient is constant for the length of the channel, and it does not depend on the depth of flow. Now, what is roughness coefficient? It is nothing but your Manning's coefficient capital N. Now, Manning's coefficient capital N, it depends upon the type of your channel boundary. आपण जो केस स्टडी बघितलं होतं एन के ऑर्चिड कॉलेजमध्ये, आपल्याला रोड साइड ड्रेन तयार करायचं होतं, त्या केस मध्ये आपण काय बघितलं होतं की इफ आय हॅव सेंट द नोट्स ऑन टीच मीट, यू कॅन जस्ट रेफर इट. मॅनिंग्स कोइफिशियंट आर डिफरंट फॉर डिफरंट चॅनेल बाउंड्रीज. जर तुमची चॅनेल बाउंड्री कॉन्क्रीट लाइनिंगची असेल तर त्याच्यासाठी वेगळं मॅनिंग्स कोइफिशियंट आहे. जर तुमची चॅनेल बाउंड्री इफ इट इज मेड अप ऑफ रॉक्स, ओके, रॉक मेसनरी, इफ इट इज मेड अप ऑफ रॉक मेसनरी, देन द रफनेस कोइफिशियंट ऑर मॅनिंग्स कोइफिशियंट एन इज डिफरंट. ओके, त्याच्यासाठी एक वेगळं आहे. जर तुमचं चॅनेल बाउंड्री सॉइलनी, क्लेई सॉइलनी बनलेलं आहे तर त्याच्यासाठी मॅनिंग्स कोइफिशियंट डिफरंट आहे. ओके, नाउ कीपिंग दिस इन माइंड, इफ इन माय चॅनेल throughout its length, if there are different channel boundaries, for example madhes tumhi concrete lining keleli aahe ya section parent, eja pudha tum kay rock masonry aahe, eja pudha kasa aahe kai concrete lining keleli nahi, rock lining keleli nahi aahe, itha kasa aahe purna clay soil aahe, tar tumcha n kay hojanar, itha change hojanar ya case madhe. Okay, now that is very difficult for solving the gradually varied flow problem. So one assumption that we make is this, that the roughness coefficient is constant for the entire length of the channel. That means instead of n1, n2, n3, you are going to have a single n, that is you are going to have a single roughness coefficient, and this roughness coefficient will not depend on the depth of flow. Karan ki gradually varied flow madhe tumcha depth change hot jato gradually, tar डेप्थ चेंज होत राहिला तर तुमची मॅनिंग्स कोइफिशियंट और रफनेस कोइफिशियंट पण चेंज होणार. सो वी विल मेक वन मोर अझम्पशन दॅट युअर रफनेस कोइफिशियंट डज नॉट डिपेंड अपॉन द डेप्थ ऑफ फ्लो. म्हणजे तुमचा डेप्थ ऑफ फ्लो चेंज झाला तरी काय प्रॉब्लेम नाही, रफनेस कोइफिशियंट तुमचा चेंज होणार नाही. अँड द लास्ट अझम्पशन इज दॅट the Chezy and Manning's correlations, or the Chezy's and Manning's formulas, are equally applicable to gradually varied flow for determining the slope of the energy line. Now this is a very important assumption. Now as you all know, this Chezy's and Manning's formula, they are used for solving numericals of uniform flow. Okay, Chezy's ani Manning's formula apan kashyache numerical solve karnyasathi ghetto, uniform flow che, uniform flow in open channel. But a gradually varied flow is not a uniform flow, it is a non-uniform flow, but still we are going to apply both these formulas in order to determine the slope of energy line. Okay, we are not going to use this formula, Chase's formula and Manning's formula, in order to find out the uniform flow, in order to find out the gradually varied flow discharge or the slope of the channel bed. We are not going to use that because it is not applicable for gradually varied flow. But we are only going to use it in gradually varied flow in order to find out the slope of energy line. Okay. Ata ya last assumption cha tumhala meaning jevha apan gradually varied flow kiti length sathi apply ahe ते डायरेक्ट स्टेप मेथड जे आपण स्टडी करणार आहे त्याच्यामध्ये तुम्हाला कळून जाईल. यू विल बी इजीली एबल टू अंडरस्टँड दिस. सो दीज आर द सेवन अझम्पशन्स. डज एनी वन हॅव एनी क्वेश्चन फॉर एनी वन ऑफ द अझम्पशन? कुठल्या अझम्पशन मध्ये कुणाला डाऊट आहे? क्वेश्चन, एनीबडी हॅज एनी क्वेश्चन?
सर, कॅन यू रिपीट द फिफ्थ अझम्पशन?
Okay, so about the energy correction factor, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, one second. So, energy correction factor is unity. It means, now, if I consider the total energy of an open channel flow, now you know when any liquid, which is a real fluid, okay, when it is flowing, the total energy is going to go on decreasing. Manje jar tumhi don teen section jar consider kele, section 1, section 2, section 3, okay, now total energy which is at section 1, okay, it will not remain the same at section 2. Section 2 varti total energy thodi reduce zaleli asnar. Why? Because due to the friction, okay, which affects the flow. Similarly, third section varti posta ajun thodi total energy flow chi kami zaleli asnar. So due to friction, total energy goes on reducing. Now this takes place for a real fluid, and the water that is going to flow through an open channel is also a real fluid, okay. So common sense says that the total energy goes on changing. But, okay, there is a term which is known as the energy correction factor alpha. Okay, we use that. Jashi tumchi total energy kami hot jati. Okay, tithe kay hot jata tumcha energy correction factor alpha apply kela jata tithe. Okay, in order to make up for the energy which has been lost. Correct. Now, what we are going to assume here that the total energy remains constant throughout the flow. Manje section 1 varti je total energy hai, ti section 2 varti hai, ani ti section 3 varti total energy. And for that assumption to be possible, we have to make the assumption that the energy correction factor alpha is unity. That means energy correction factor is 1. आणि इथं जर 1 अल्फाची व्हॅल्यू 1 असेल तर टोटल एनर्जी जी सेक्शन 1 वरती आहे ती सेक्शन 2 वरती असणार आणि ती सेक्शन 3 वरती असणार. ओके, देर विल बी नो लॉस इन द टोटल एनर्जी. दॅट इज द अझम्पशन दॅट वी आर गोइंग टू मेक व्हाइल डिराइविंग द डायनामिक इक्वेशन ऑफ ग्रॅज्युअली व्हेरिड फ्लो. सो हॅव यू अंडरस्टूड?
यस सर.
Okay, any other questions?
No, sir.
Okay, so should we proceed?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we finished with the assumption. Now we'll start with the derivation. Okay. So for the derivation, we are going to consider a simple rectangular channel having gradually varied flow, in which the depth of flow is gradually decreasing in the direction of flow. So So you can see here, this is the rectangular channel. This is the front view that I am seeing of the rectangular channel. Okay. Let D be the bottom width of the channel. Let Y be the depth of the flow. Now, you can see here the side view of the channel. Here the water is flowing. And here the depth of flow is gradually decreasing in the direction of the flow. Manje jasa tumhi ita bahu shakta hai. Ita zar y depth asel. And itli zar mi dusri depth consider keli y1. So y is greater than y1 because the depth is decreasing in the direction of the flow. Okay. Now, this is the horizontal datum. This is the bottom of the channel, or it is also known as the channel bed. Okay. This is the free surface of water. And this is the pink dotted line is nothing but the energy line, or the it is also known as the total energy line. Okay. Now we'll use the Bernoulli's equation in order to denote all the three energies. Z represents the datum energy. Y represents the pressure energy. And V square upon 2G represents the kinetic energy or the velocity head. Now, let small b be the width of the channel. Let capital Q be the discharge through the channel, which is going to remain constant throughout the flow. That one thing I want to make clear. Okay. Let Z be the height of bottom of the channel above the datum. Okay. So your bottom of the channel chi height above the horizontal datum kiti ahe z. So z is the potential energy or the datum head. Y is the depth of the flow. Let v be the mean velocity of the flow. Ata mean velocity is artha kay asta hai. Now for a liquid, I'll just show in this itself. Now you know that the velocity at the boundary is zero. And we know the distribution of the velocity in an open channel. Kasa distribution ahe? Velocity is maximum at some distance below the surface. Okay. Ani velocity is zero at the boundary. So this is the distribution of the channel at each layer. Kar aplela each layer la different aplela velocity kadaychi garaj nahi. We have to take the mean velocity of the entire flow at a particular section. So let V be the mean velocity of the flow. Let SB be tan B equal to tan I, which is equal to I, that is the slope of the channel bed. Tar he I kaya hai? It is nothing but the angle that the channel bottom or the channel bed makes with the horizontal. So this is the angle I. Now tan I will be equal to I. Why? Because this angle I is very small. Kan ki apan ek assumption kai kelela hai gradually varied flow madhe, that the slope is bed slope is very small. So this I, which is the angle of the slope, it is very small. Tan I is equal to I. Okay, and this tan I is represented by SB or the slope of the bed. Next, J. What is the J? It is the angle between the slope of the energy line. Okay, slope of the energy line and the horizontal. Okay, now everyone, please mute themselves. Now everyone should mute themselves. If anybody unmutes himself or herself, I am going to remove you from the meeting. Okay, so keep that in mind. Now, so this tan J, this angle J is very small. So tan J is equal to J, which is nothing but the slope of this energy line. So we have got two slopes. One slope, we have got the slope of channel bed, which is represented by SB. And second is the slope of the energy line, which is denoted by SE, or slope of the energy line. Okay. Please take the screenshot, or you can at least draw the diagram. Okay, so have you taken the screenshot?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now let us derive. We have seen the different terms related to the derivation. Now we'll start deriving. So according to Bernoulli's equation, the energy equation at any section will be given by capital E, which represents the total energy, will be equal to Z plus Y plus V square upon 2G, where Z is the potential energy, Y is the pressure energy, and V square upon 2G is the kinetic energy. Now this is, mark this as equation number 1. Okay, it is a very important derivation, so everybody should pay attention. Now what we will do here, we'll take the bottom of the channel as the x-axis. Okay, we'll take the bottom of the channel as the x-axis, and the vertically upwards direction measured from the channel bottom as the y-axis. So this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis. And what we'll do, we are going to differentiate this equation number 1 with respect to x. Now what is x? It is nothing but the direction x. So we are going to differentiate this energy equation with respect to direction x. Manjes kay x direction manje kay tumcha flow cha direction ahe. Tar flow cha direction madhe tumchi energy kashi change honar, that we are going to see. So we'll derive this. So deriving equation 1 with respect to x, we get dE upon dx is equal to dz upon dx plus dy upon dx plus dy dx into bracket v square upon 2g. Okay, I'll mark this as equation number 2. Now out of this equation number 2, I'll just, for the time being, I'll neglect these three terms. And I'll just now focus myself on this fourth term, that is dy dx with respect to v square upon d by dx into bracket v square upon 2g. Okay. So I'll solve this fourth term, d by dx into v square upon 2g. Now v, as you all know, discharge is equal to velocity into area, or area into velocity. Therefore velocity will be nothing but discharge upon area, whole bracket square. This is whole bracket square. D by dx into q by a, whole bracket square upon 2g. Now area, as it is a rectangular channel and we have considered V is the base width and Y is the depth of the flow. So the area of the rectangular channel will be B into Y. So D by dx into bracket q by B Y, whole bracket square divided by 2g. Okay. So have you understood up to this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what we have done is we have taken the Bernoulli's equation for open channel. We have derived it with respect to the direction of the flow, that is x direction. Okay. Now, dE by dx, it represents the change in the energy with respect to the direction of the flow. dz by dx represents the change in the datum, okay, with respect to direction of the flow x, and dy by dx, it represents the change in depth with respect to the direction of the flow. Okay, and we are going to neglect this first three and we are going to focus ourselves on the fourth term. So we have found out d by dx into bracket v square upon 2g will form d by dx into bracket q by dy whole bracket square upon 2g. आता हा जो लास्ट चा टर्म आहे मी आहे तसं मी नेक्स्ट स्लाइड वरती कॉपी केलेला आहे, सो इट इज इजी फॉर यू टू अंडरस्टँड. सो लेट अस सी, तर आहे तसं कॉपी केले मी लास्ट स्लाइड मधलं जी लास्ट डेरिवेशन होत ते इक्वेशन. नाउ हियर व्हाट वी विल डू इज q square numerator la tune b upon y whole bracket b into y whole bracket square, I'll take it to the denominator. So d by dx into bracket q square upon b square y square 2g. Okay, ata apan derive kartoy with respect to the x direction. Ata with respect to x direction kai kai change honar ahe te apan baghuya. Is q going to change with respect to x direction? No, because we know discharge, the flow is steady and hence the discharge is going to remain constant throughout the flow. So discharge q is not going to change with respect to x. Is b going to change base bottom width? No, the channel is prismatic, that means there is no change in the cross sectional area, and if there is no change in the cross sectional area, that means your bottom width or base width b is also going to remain constant. Okay, so this b is not going to change with respect to x. Y depth change honar hai ka with respect to x? Yes, it is a gradually varied flow, so in the direction of the flow your depth is going to change. Okay, ani survatila sangitle the depth goes on decreasing in the direction of the flow, so your depth is going to change. And g going to change? Gravitational acceleration is not going to change. मग जे जे चेंज होत नाही ते डेरिवेशनच्या बाहेर ठेवतो मी. क्यू स्क्वेअर अपॉन बी स्क्वेअर इंटू टू जी इंटू डी वाय डी एक्स इंटू ब्रॅकेट वन अपॉन वाय स्क्वेअर, बिकॉज ओनली वाय स्क्वेअर इज डिपेंड विल चेंज विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द एक्स डायरेक्शन. ओके, नाउ सॉल्विंग फर्दर, क्यू स्क्वेअर अपॉन बी स्क्वेअर 2g into, I'll derive this y square with respect to x. Tal mala kay bhetnar? I'll get q square upon b square 2g into 1 upon y square cha derivation minus 2 upon y cube minus 2 upon y cube into dy by dx. ओके, काय केलेला इथं 1 अपॉन y स्क्वेअर d बाय dx, तर काय ना 1 अपॉन y स्क्वेअरचं काय येणार मायनस 2 अपॉन y क्यूब इंटू dy बाय dx. दिस इज सिंपल डेरिवेशन, एव्हरीबडी शुड नो दिस. So here, now what will happen if you see this equation here? These two will get cancelled. That means these two will get cancelled. So it will remain minus q square upon b square y b square g into y cube. आता या y cube मतलब काय करायचं? Y square वेगळं करायचं आणि एक y वेगळं करायचं. So minus q square upon b square y square into g y into dy by dx. Now if you consider this q square upon b square y square, tar kay milnar tumhala? What are you going to get?
Velocity.
Good, because this is q square upon q square upon b square y square is nothing but by square. So q square upon by is nothing but area square, and q upon a is nothing but velocity. Okay, so what I've got is, we had started with deriving this equation, dou by dou x into v square upon 2g, so four term hota. Okay, let me just go to the last slide. Okay, आपण इक्वेशन नंबर 2 डिराइव करतोय. आपण हे पहिले तीन टर्म्स इग्नोर केले, डी बाय डी एक्स इंटू ब्रॅकेट वी स्क्वेअर अपॉन टू जी, हे जे आपण डेरिव्हेशन करायला लागलोय. ओके, तर लास्टली आपल्याला सगळं डिराईव्ह करून आपल्याला काय भेटलेलं आहे, डी बाय डी एक्स इंटू ब्रॅकेट वी स्क्वेअर अपॉन टू जी इज नथिंग बट मायनस वी स्क्वेअर मायनस क्यू स्क्वेअर अपॉन बी स्क्वेअर वाय स्क्वेअर, म्हणजे काय मायनस वी स्क्वेअर. सो मायनस वी स्क्वेअर अपॉन जी वाय इंटू डी वाय बाय डी एक्स. Okay, so have you understood up to this point? Yes, have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what I'm going to do again is, I'm going to take this last equation of this slide and I'll transfer it as it is on the next. So next, what we are going to do, substituting the value of d by dx v square upon 2g in equation number 2. Equation number 2 kya hota, let me just write it here, dE by dx is equal to dz by dx plus dy by dx plus d by dx into bracket v square upon 2g. हा तुमचा इक्वेशन नंबर 2 होता. Now we are going to substitute the value of d by dx into bracket v square upon 2g from the last equation of the last slide. तर आपल्याला डिराइव करून काय भेटेल, सबस्टिट्यूट करून काय भेटेल, सॉरी, dE by dx is equal to dz by dx plus dy by dx plus minus v square upon gy into dy by dx, जे की आपल्याला लास्ट स्लाइड मध्ये भेटलेलं आहे. ओके, नाउ हियर अगेन सॉल्विंग फर्दर, dE by dx is equal to dz by dx plus, आता इथे dy by dx आणि dy by dx चे दोन टर्म्स आहेत, तर dy by dx at constant tune, what I'll get? What I'm going to get? dE by dx is equal to dz by dx plus dy by dx into bracket 1 minus v square upon gy, which is equation number 3. Okay? Now, dE by dx is nothing but change in the energy with respect to the direction of flow, that means with respect to x direction, and it is nothing but your tan j, and tan j is nothing but your slope of energy line SE. So dE by dx is nothing but minus SE. Similarly, dz by dx is nothing but the change of the datum with respect to the x direction, that means the direction of the flow, and it is represented by tan I, that is slope of the bed of the channel or slope of the bottom of the channel, which is denoted by SB. Okay, so dz by dx is equal to minus SB. Now why have we used minus sign for both these cases? It is because minus signs with SE and SB indicate that the value of E and Z, that means the value of energy and the value of this Z, they go on decreasing with the increase of X. That means as we go further in the direction of the flow, energy as well as this value of Z is going to go on decreasing. Okay. I hope you have understood up to this point. AC and SV kutna ale kaale ga tumhala? Yes. Yes. आपल्याला एस सी आणि एस बी कुठून मिळालेला आहे? रोल नंबर 39. रोल नंबर 41. रोल नंबर 44. रोल नंबर 17. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then, अरे मग ऐकू येते तर मग कोणतरी उत्तर द्या. Is S, SE आणि SB कुठून आलं कळालं का तुम्हाला?
हो सर.
Yes. हो सर.
So now what you do, again in equation number 3, you substitute the value of DE and DZ, DE upon DX and DZ upon DA. So what we'll get is, substituting the value of DE by DX and DZ by DX in equation number 3, we get, instead of DE by DX, we have got minus SE. Instead of DZ by DX, we have got minus SB plus 1 minus v square upon gy into dy by dx. Or here, what will happen? I'll take sb upon sb minus se on one side. Ha jo right hand side cha sb hai, tumhi left hand side la ghetto. Sb minus se is equal to 1 minus v square upon 2g into dy by dx. Okay. Now what I'll do, I'll take this 1 minus v square upon 2g, which is on the numerator, I'll take it to the denominator on the left hand side. So dy by dx is equal to sb minus se upon 1 minus v square upon gy. Okay, but you know the formula for Froude's number. Froude's number is equal to v upon square root of gy. So therefore, square of Froude number will be equal to v square upon gy. So this v square upon gy is nothing but the Froude's number. So the formula will be dy by dx is equal to sb minus se upon 1 minus fr square. So what is this dy by dx represent? It is the change in depth in the direction of the flow. Tar gradually varied flow madhe depth jasa tumcha change honar aahe in the direction of the flow, tyachyasathi ek aplyala formula aahe, tya formula ni apan find out karu shaktoy ki kiti na tumchi depth change honar aahe with respect to the direction of the flow. Tyacha formula kay aahe? Sb minus se upon 1 minus fr square. Okay, now मागच्या स्लाइड मधला आहे तसा फॉर्म्युला घेतलाय, डीवाय बाय डीएक्स इज इक्वल टू एस बी मायनस एस सी अपॉन 1 मायनस एफ आर स्क्वेअर. नाव द डीवाय बाय डीएक्स रिप्रेझेंट्स द व्हेरिएशन ऑफ डेप्थ अलॉंग द बॉटम ऑफ द चॅनल अँड इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द स्लोप ऑफ द फ्री वॉटर सरफेस. सो दिस डीवाय बाय डीएक्स रिप्रेझेंट्स द स्लोप ऑफ द फ्री वॉटर सरफेस. ओके, आता त्याचे एक्झाम्पल्स मी तुम्हाला देतो. फर्स्ट वील सी द डिफरंट कंडिशन, वील क्लासिफाय द डिफरंट स्लोप्स. नाउ व्हेन डीवाय बाय डीएक्स इज इक्वल टू झिरो, ओके, दॅट मीन्स व्हेन दिस होल टर्म इज इक्वल टू झिरो, दॅट इट मीन्स दॅट देर इज नो चेंज इन डेप्थ ऑफ फ्लो विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स डायरेक्शन. Okay, or it means that the depth is constant, y is constant, and it means that the free water surface is parallel to the channel bed. So tumcha channel bed asnar ahe, tumcha free water surface tela parallel asnar ahe, and it will be called as the uniform flow, and the flow will be called as uniform flow when dy by dx chi value tumchi zero in kadhi sb minus sc upon 1 minus fr square jeva tumhi solve karnar. सॉल्व केल्यानंतर ती व्हॅल्यू जर झिरो आली तर त्याचा अर्थ काय, तुमचं फ्लो युनिफॉर्म फ्लो आहे, युअर डेप्थ इज कॉन्स्टंट. दॅट इज द फर्स्ट कंडिशन. सेकंड कंडिशन, इफ डीवाय बाय डीएक्स ची व्हॅल्यू तुमची झिरो पेक्षा मोठी आली, दॅट इट मीन्स दॅट द डेप्थ ऑफ फ्लो इन्क्रीजेस इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द फ्लो अँड द प्रोफाइल ऑफ वॉटर सो ऑब्टेंड इज कॉल्ड द बॅक वॉटर कर्व. ओके, आणि हे कुठल्या केस मध्ये होणार आहे, फॉर एक्झाम्पल इफ यू कन्स्ट्रक्ट अ ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन, इफ यू कन्स्ट्रक्ट अन ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन, तर फॉर एक्झाम्पल वियर यू हॅव कन्स्ट्रक्टेड, आणि इथं कसं आहे तुम्हाला काल सांगितलं होतं, इफ यू कन्स्ट्रक्ट अ वियर त्यात कसं होणार आहे, ऍज वी गो अप टू द अपस्ट्रीम साइड द डेप्थ इज गोइंग टू गो ऑन डिक्रीजिंग. Okay, and it is an example of gradual varied flow. But if you see in the case of in the direction of the flow, tar itte tumhala kasa dishte, the depth is going on increasing in the direction of the flow, and it happens when dy by dx value is greater than zero, and this type of a curve is known as a backwater curve. It is known as a backwater curve. Okay, now we'll see the third condition. If dy by dx is less than 0, it indicates that the depth of water decreases in the direction of flow. In the profile of water in this case so obtained is known as the drop down curve. Tar for example, ek mi case dakhavto tumhala. If there is a gate, okay, if there is a gate which has been lifted up, ita water flow hoya lagla hai. ओके, आणि एक तुम्ही गेट लिफ्ट केलेला आहे, तर या केस मध्ये तो डेप्थ कशी होणार आहे, इट इज गोइंग टू डिक्रीज इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द फ्लो. ओके, तर या केस मध्ये काय होतं, डीवाय बाय डीएक्स इज लेस दॅन झिरो. ओके, आणि हा जो कर्व येणार आहे त्याला काय म्हणतो आपण, इट इज नोन एज ड्रॉप डाऊन कर्व ऑर ड्रॉ डाऊन कर्व इट इज नोन एज. ओके, सो हॅव यू अंडरस्टूड. इथपर्यंत कळालेलं आहे का?
यस सर.
सो आफ्टर द एंड ऑफ द लेक्चर टुडे प्लीज डू अ रिव्हिजन. ओके, आय विल बी अपलोडिंग येस्टरडेज लेक्चर अँड टुडेज लेक्चर बाय आफ्टरनून इन विद इन वन ऑर वन अँड हाफ आवर्स. सो यू कॅन वॉच द लेक्चर अँड यू कॅन डू सेल्फ स्टडी. सो एनी डाऊट, एनी क्वेश्चन? So we have derived the dynamic equation of gradually varied flow in which dy by dx is equal to sb minus sc upon 1 minus fr square, where dy by dx is nothing but the change in depth with respect to the direction of the flow, sb is nothing but the slope of channel bed, sc is nothing but the slope of energy line, fr is nothing but the Froude's number. Now if dy by dx is equal to 0 zar ala apla, that means the flow is uniform and y is constant. If dy by dx is greater than 0, it indicates the depth of water increases in the direction of the flow, and the curve is known as the backwater curve. Okay, tumhi aikla asel dam cha weir cha je upstream side la pani asta tela apan kay mhanto, backwater mhanto. Okay, ujni cha backwater, koyna dharne cha backwater. Okay, tyamule ha jo curve obtained ahe tela pan apan kay mhanto, बॅकवॉटर कर्व. because it increases in the direction of the flow. Okay. And if third condition, if dy by dx is less than zero, it indicates that the depth of water decreases in the direction of the flow. And the profile of water which we are going to obtain is known as the drop down or drawdown curve. Drop down peksha tela ek dusra naav ahe, which is commonly used, it is drawdown curve. Okay. So any doubt, any questions?
No, sir. Thank you, sir.
So in the next lecture, we will be solving some numericals on the dynamic equation of gradually varied flow. Okay. Now our next lecture will probably be on Monday. Yes, it will be on Monday itself. So we'll solve numericals. So before coming for the Monday's lecture, everyone should at least watch the video. Okay. And if you write down the equation in your notebook while watching the video, it is very good. So before coming to Monday's lecture, when we are going to solve the numericals, come prepared. Okay. Thank you, everyone. I'll stop the lecture here. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.